Good morning, students. Today we have to start from page 40. First paragraph in the course of the next 2 hours. So what happened? This man and his dog, the husky, were walking. The dog was reluctant to move ahead, unwilling to move ahead, but he was kind of forced by the man to accompany him. The dog had his instincts, right? And his instincts warned him that he should not travel in such cold temperatures, right? When the temperatures are 75 below zero, they should not travel. They should sit next to the fire. This is what the dog said. And the man, because of his education, because the man was educated, and so he tried to defy everything. Defy the suggestions, the advice, and his instincts also. So what happened? In the course of the next 2 hours, he came upon several similar traps. So he came upon several similar traps where there was a layer of ice, and underneath that layer of ice, there was water from the springs. Usually the snow above the hidden pools had a sunken candied appearance. Candied means that means when the sugar is crystallized, that kind of encrusted kind of an appearance. So on top of it, ice gave the appearance on the top of that pool. The ice gave the appearance of a crust, and underneath there was water. He came across several these types of pools that advertised the danger, and these were very dangerous. Why were they dangerous? What would happen if he goes inside one such pool? You have seen in the movie. I've already showed you the movie. Ansh, what would happen? Ansh? So once again, however, he had to close call. So once again, he was saved closely, right? Means somehow he managed to save himself once again, right? From getting into that trap. And once suspecting danger, he compelled the dog to go on in front. You saw this in the movie, right? When he sensed danger, he ask the dog to go in front. This is how selfish man is. Whenever he senses danger, he sends the dog to move in front. So that if anyone is supposed to go inside water, it should be the dog. And he is safe. The dog did not want to go. But the instincts of the dog, it prompted him that this is dangerous. From the very beginning, the dog is aware of the fact that things can be dangerous. So the dog did not want to go in front. It hung back until the man shoved it forward. It was reluctant. It didn't want to move forward. It hung back. It stayed there till the man shoved it forward. Till the man pushed the dog, forced the dog to move forward. And then it went quickly across the white unbroken surface. And when the dog was forced by the man, it quickly went forward across the white unbroken surface, because the dog sensed the danger. The instincts of the dog prompted him that this can be dangerous, and so it went quickly through that unbroken surface. Suddenly broke. And when the dog was moving, the ice, the crust of ice, it broke. Floundered to one side. Floundered means moved to one side with a lot of, in a very, like when you are facing a lot of difficulty, the dog moved to one side and got away to firmer footing. The moment the dogs went inside the water, It quickly tried to save himself and moved towards one side where the ice was firm. Right? Where the crust of ice was thicker, it moved to that side. Plundered to one side and got away to firmer footing. Right? Where the ice was firm, where the ice was unbroken, the dog immediately reacted. Right? It had wet its forefeet and legs. But still, the forefeet and legs of dog were wet. And almost immediately, the water that clung to it turned into ice. Because it was so cold, so the water turned into ice immediately. It made quick efforts to lick the ice off its leg. See, these were the instincts of the dog. The dog knew that he should, the first thing he needs to do is to remove this ice. This ice which has been formed on its feet, forefeet and legs, he should get rid of this ice immediately. Right? So the dog started licking the ice off its leg. Then dropped down in the snow and began to bite out the ice that had formed between his feet. Even the ice, because it was water, so the ice between the toes, the ice which was formed between the toes. So that also it tried to bite. He used his mouth to remove that ice, his teeth to remove that ice. He knew, he was very well aware of this fact that he should get rid of ice as soon as possible. So he immediately fell on the ice, sat on the ice and started removing the ice from his forefeet and legs. This was a matter of instinct. Animals, they never go against nature, right? So it was dog's instincts which prompted him. He was not educated. He didn't go to any school or he didn't have any knowledge. But his instincts told him that the first thing he needs to do is to get rid of this ice from every single part of his body. So he even started biting the ice which were formed between his toes. To permit the ice to remain would mean sore feet. The dog understood this. This was told by the instincts of the dog that it would mean sore feet. His feet will start paining. He will start suffering if he doesn't get rid of the ice. So he tried to get rid of the ice as soon as possible. It did not notice. It merely obeyed the mysterious prompting that arose from the deep crypts of its being. So he only understood this, that this was dangerous. What all complications this can have, this technical complications this ice can have, the dog was not aware of this fact. But he only knew the instincts prompted him that this, because of this ice, he might suffer. So the technicalities of the suffering, the dog was not aware of. Right? So, but there was something inside him, that mysterious prompting, which we call instinct. There was that mysterious prompting, something from inside the dog prompted him that he should get rid of the ice, and so he started working. Right? So crypt means crypts of his being. What is the meaning of crypts? From the deep pit inside. Right? So from deep down inside him, crypt also means underground room kind of a thing. So from deep inside him, something prompted, some mysterious thing inside the dog prompted, which we call as instinct, told the dog that he has to remove the ice. And so the dog started licking and biting it from its feet and hooves. But the man knew, having achieved the judgment on the subject, and he removed the mittens from his right hand and helped tear out the ice part. The man also helped the dog. See, the man knew, because man had knowledge. The dog had instinct, right? So dog didn't know the technicalities and the problems which can arise because of this ice. But the man knew, because the man had knowledge. The dog only knew, the dog was only aware that there is something inside him which is telling him to get this ice, to shed off this ice from his body. So the dog started working on it. But the man knew the technicalities of having ice on the body and the problems. He was aware of everything, what this can lead to, because the man was educated. So the man removed his mittens, the gloves which he was wearing, and he right hand and held tear of the ice particle, and he helped to remove the particles of ice from his feet. He did not expose his fingers more than a minute and was astonished at the swift numbness that smote him. Right? So smote them means to hit something hard. Right? So the man did not expose his fingers. The moment he removed his mittens, the gloves which he was wearing to help the dog take out that ice, so he was shocked to see that his fingers became numb immediately. The moment they were removed, they became numb. It certainly was cold. So now slowly the man started realizing the severity of the weather. He felt that, he realized that it was certainly very cold. He pulled on the mittens hastily and beat the hand savagely across his chest, because his fingers, his hand went numb. So he immediately pulled back his mittens, the gloves which he was wearing, and started beating his hand against his chest so that the blood circulation is proper and the numbness from his hand goes away. At 12 o'clock, the day was at its bright, yet the sun was too far south on its winter journey to clear the horizon. So at 12 o'clock, it was the brightest time of the day during such weather. The sun was nowhere to be seen, too far south, away from the horizon. The bulge of the earth intervened between it and Henderson, right? Where the man walked under a clear sky at noon and cast no shadow. Because there was no sun, so obviously he will cast no shadow. At 12:30, to a minute, he arrived at the forks of the tree. So he almost at 12:30, he arrived at the forks where he decided to have his lunch. In the beginning, we have read that he decided that once he reaches the fox, he will have his lunch. He was pleased at the speed he has made. And he was very happy that he has maintained the speed and he has approximately achieved his objective. Right? He wanted to be there at this time at the fox. And so he had reached the fox of the creek. Fox means where it is divided into two. So he had reached that place on time. He was very happy at his achievement. If he kept it up, he would certainly be with the boys by 6. And he knew that if he kept this speed, if he maintained his pace, he will be with the boys by 6 in the evening. He unbuttoned his jacket and shirt and drew forth his lunch. So he took out his lunch. The action consumed no more than a quarter of a minute. And he took no more than a quarter of a minute to do this, right? Yet in that brief moment, the numbness laid hold on the exposed. He had just a quarter of a minute he took to unbutton his shirt and take out the lunch which was there inside his shirt, right? You remember, he had kept his lunch, the packet of lunch, inside his shirt. Why had he done so? So that it remains warm and it doesn't freeze. So he took out his lunch and the time he took was just a quarter of a minute, and yet in that brief moment the numbness laid hold on the exposed finger. So in that brief time, what happened? His fingers, they went numb. He did not put the mittens on, but instead struck the finger a dozen sharp smashes against his leg. So he didn't put back his mittens. Instead, he started beating his fingers on his legs. Then he sat down on a snow-covered log. The sting that followed upon the striking of his fingers against his legs ceased so quickly that he was stunned. The stinging. See, once you hit your hand at something, obviously the fingers will start stinging. You will feel some pain because of hitting. But the pain disappeared so quickly that he was shocked, right? He hit his fingers against his leg really hard, right? so that the blood circulation is proper, because they just went numb in quarter of a minute. So he and he was shocked to see how quickly the pain, the sensation of pain. See, once any part of your body goes numb, you will not feel anything in that part of your body, whether it is pain, whether it is any other sensation, right? So he was shocked to see that his fingers, the pain, the stinging sensation on his which he was there on his finger, it disappeared very quickly. He had had no chance to take a bite of this. So though he took out the biscuits, he didn't get a chance to have a bite. He struck the fingers repeatedly and returned them to the middle. So, because the fingers were numb, so he couldn't feel any sensation in his fingers. So, he again struck the fingers repeatedly, hard, and returned them to the mittens. Again, he wore the mittens, barring the other hand for the purpose of eating, right? And the other hand, used for the purpose of eating. He tried to take a mouthful, but the ice muzzle prevented. You remember that ice muzzle which was formed on his mouth because of his breath, right? The breath which he exhaled and the tobacco which he was eating and he was spitting. So it was not falling on the ground. It was forming a muzzle kind of a thing, the covering over his mouth. Right, so that covering of ice over his mouth, it prevented him from moving his mouth and eating, from opening his mouth. He tried to take a mouthful, but the ice muzzle prevented. He had forgotten to build a fire and fall. So he had forgotten to build a fire and get rid of that. He chuckled at his foolishness, and then he smiled at his foolishness. That the first thing he should have done was to light a fire so that he could have got rid of that ice on his face. And as he chuckled, he noted the numbness creeping into the exposed finger. So he wore the mittens only on one hand, and the other hand he left for eating, right? So because he was about to have his lunch. So he realized when he was chuckling at his foolishness, he realized that slowly the numbness has started creeping into that exposed finger. The finger which was without mittens, it had started becoming numb. Also, he noted the stinging which had first come to his toes when he sat down was already passing. So, the stinging sensation when he sat down, right, because he had been walking for a long time. So, the stinging sensation on his toes, which he felt when he immediately sat down, because both the body was in motion. When the body is in motion, it is warm. But when he sat down, slowly his feet also started becoming numb. So when the feet also will become numb, the pain, the stinging sensation will also disappear. So when he sat down, was already passing away. It was already going. He wondered whether the toes were warm or not. Then he started thinking whether his toes are still warm or they have become numb. He moved them inside the mukhasans and decided that they were numb. He tried to move his toes, right? Inside the shoes which he was wearing, that those thick shoes which he was wearing. So mukhasans are the shoes. So which he was wearing, he tried to move his toes inside those shoes. But he realized, he came to the conclusion that they were all numb, right? There was no sensation on his. He pulled the mittens on hurriedly and stood up. So he immediately realized that he had to save his toes and feet because they were already going numb. So he immediately pulled on the gloves and stood up. He was a bit frightened. So now that fright started, that fear started creeping inside, right? So he was a bit frightened. He stamped up and down until the stinging returned into his feet. So he started stamping his feet up and down till that stinging sensation in his feet was retrieved. It came back. Till that time he was stamping his feet on the ground. It certainly was cold. was his thought. So now his thought started changing. You felt that it certainly was very cold. The man from Sulphur Creek had spoken the truth when telling how cold it sometimes got in the country. Because he was a Chechico, right? You know that he was new in this to this place, right? This was the first time that he was in this place. So an experienced man, the man from the Sulphur Creek, had already warned him how cold it could be in this country. Sometimes it is very cold in this country, in this place. He was warned by an experienced person, but still he ignored his advice. And he had laughed at him at that time. So his ego, his confidence in himself made him mock at that man. He had laughed at him at that time. That showed one must not be too sure of things. This showed that one must not be too sure of things. Right? There was no mistake about it. It was cool. Right? He was very sure of himself. So, but now slowly he started realizing that it was very cold. The man, he was thinking about what he was told by the man he met at the Sulphur Creek, that experienced man, right? So when this thought started entering his mind, it means that he is now somewhat in agreement with the thoughts of that man he met at the Sulphur Creek. There was no mistake about it. It was cold. He strode up and down, stamping his feet and threshing his arms. Threshing his arms means he was beating his arms, right? Striking his arms repeatedly. He was doing this so that the sensation, the numbness, which has said the sensation in his hands and feet is restored, right? And the numbness goes away. Until reassured by the returning warmth. And when he did this for some time, the warmth of his body was back. Then he got out matches and proceeded to make the fire. Then he took out the matches from his pocket and moved ahead to make some fire for himself. From the undergrowth where high water of the previous spring has lost a supply of seasoned twigs, he got his firewood. So to burn a fire, he picked some twigs which were there, lying there. Working carefully from a small beginning, he soon had a roaring fire over which he thawed the ice from his face. So because of the heat of the fire, the ice which had formed a muzzle, a covering over his mouth, that was removed. And thawed the ice from his face, and in the protection of which he ate his biscuit. He took his lunch sitting next to that fire. For the moment, the cold of his face was out. So for some time, the cold of this area was outwitted, means it was defeated. Because he was sitting next to the fire, and fire provides warmth. Everyone knows this. So for some time, by doing this, he was able to outwit the cold. Means he was able to defeat the cold of this space. The dog took satisfaction in the fire. The dog, from all this while, was desperately wanting fire, and now because the dog got fire, so he was satisfied. Stretching out close enough for warmth and far enough away to escape being singed. So singed means to be burned, right? So the dog stretched his body at a place where he could receive the warmth of the fire and save himself from being burned. So he maintained proper distance, proper comfortable distance from the fire, so that he is able to receive the warmth from the fire and also to save himself from being burned, right? So I think we should stop here and we'll continue on the next time.